chapter 15, and I'll begin reading in verse 21. Hear the word of God. Leaving that place, Jesus withdrew to the region of Tyre and Sidon. A Canaanite woman from that vicinity came to him, crying out, "Lord, Son of David, have mercy on me. My daughter is demon-possessed and suffering terribly." Jesus did not answer a word. So his disciples came to him and urged him, "Send her away, for she keeps crying out after us." He answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of Israel." The woman came and knelt before him. "Lord, help me," she said. He replied, "It is not right to take the children's bread and toss it to the dogs." "Yes, it is, Lord," she said. "Even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from their master's table." Then Jesus said to her, "Woman, you have great faith. Your request is granted," and her daughter was healed at that moment. May the Lord add his blessing to the reading of his holy word. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for your word and how it speaks to our hearts, and we pray now that you would open up our hearts so that your word may speak deeply to us. The story of Joseph revealing his identity to his brothers, and this is a story in the New Testament. The Canaanite woman, and Jesus and the disciples, and this lesson that he taught his disciples here. Lord, we pray that we would learn it also. So open up our hearts and minds to your word and bless us as we hear your word. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Get out a pencil and paper. Didn't you just hate those words when you were in school back in the day, those surprise quizzes? I know that they sent a shockwave through me because I was not always prepared. My submission to you this morning is that God gives us surprise tests. Sometimes we fail them. Sometimes we pass. God is not out to break us so that we hang our heads about our failures. Rather, God is out to make us, to help prepare us to be effective servants in God's kingdom. So to learn more about these surprise tests that God gives to us, I'd like to take a closer look at these two examples, the one from the Old Testament that Ryan read and this one from the New Testament that I just read to you. And let's see if we can learn something about these surprise tests. Now, our story from the Old Testament, the story about Joseph revealing his identity to his brother, some theologians would disagree with me on the point that this was a surprise test from God. They would say, no. They would say, this it is really about Joseph's desire for revenge and his manipulative and deceptive means of exacting this revenge on these brothers who sold him into slavery. For example, these theologians would say that Joseph deceived his brothers. He pretended not to know them. Then he accused them of spying, and he throws them in jail for 3 days. Then he insists that they bring back the youngest son, Benjamin, and he holds one of the brothers, Simeon, as hostage to guarantee that they return. And then the final straw of this manipulation and deception that these theologians would point to would be when Joseph slipped the silver cup into Benjamin's sack to set up a charge of stealing against Benjamin. So these theologians of opinion, Joseph isn't the good guy that we make him out to be, but I disagree with them. The reason God didn't want these brothers to know what was really going on was this was a surprise test, a pop quiz. Whenever a teacher gives a pop quiz, there are specific reasons she does so. She wants the class to know the material. She expects them to pay attention. They need to assimilate what they're hearing in the classroom, that they need to be prepared. These are the reasons that a teacher will give a pop test to keep those students on guard at all times. You have those kind of teachers. Through Joseph, God was testing these brothers. Through this test, God wasn't out to break the family into 100 pieces, but God rather was out to make this family into a nation. They needed to grow spiritually. They needed to be transformed on the inside. They needed to refocus their priorities on the right things in life. Were they ready to fulfill God's calling? Were they the same jealous, heartless, callous men who sold their brother Joseph into slavery? Well, in our scripture lesson this morning, we arrive at that critical point where we find out the answer to those questions. At the end of Genesis chapter 44, Judah, one of the brothers, appeals to Joseph for the life of his youngest brother, Benjamin, whom Joseph has put in jail. Joseph was holding him on that charge of stealing the silver cup. This is what Judah says to him, Genesis 44, 33 and 34. "Now then, please let your servant remain here as my lord's slave in place of the boy, and let the boy return with his brothers. How can I go back to my father if the boy is not with me? No, do not let me see the misery that would come on my father." So how did they do on this test that God was giving them through Joseph? They got an A+. These brothers lived for years with the guilt and the regret of selling Joseph into slavery. They saw what it did to their father. When Benjamin, the youngest brother, became their father's favorite, they had learned their lesson. They didn't plot against Benjamin like they did against Joseph. They accepted it. In fact, Judah did just the opposite. What did he do? He said, "I am willing to sacrifice myself. I'm willing to become a slave in place of my brother Benjamin because I do not want to see my father suffer." So he had changed so much, he got to the point where he was willing to sacrifice himself so that his brother and his father would not suffer. Isn't that the ultimate transformation that a person can go through? Going from being self-centered and jealous and bitter to being others-centered and self-sacrificing. This answer to the pop quiz that God gave caused Joseph to break down. Joseph saw the bigger picture. He saw what God had done through the hearts of his brothers down through these years. He understood that God worked through all those negatives. God worked through all the dysfunctionality of that family. Worked through all the failures of that family to bring them to this place of healing and wholeness. Listen to what Joseph says to them. Genesis 45, 4 and 5, "Then Joseph said to his brothers, 'Come close to me.' When they had done so, he said, 'I am your brother Joseph, the one you sold in Egypt. And now, do not be distressed and do not be angry with yourselves for selling me here, because it was to save lives that God sent me ahead of you.'" It's as if Joseph had been raised up to this new perspective, and from up there he could see the entire picture. He saw the entire roadmap. He said, "Listen, God's purpose is to save lives. God's purpose is to give life, abundant and full, the life of God. To do this, God works through negatives. God works through brokenness. God works through the bad things that happen, and from it, he has the power to restore life. Joseph said, God has taken us from the brokenness of these years gone by, and now he has given us a brand new opportunity. Now that is quite a life lesson. That was some pop quiz. Now how about Jesus? Did Jesus ever give his disciples pop quizzes? I think so. I think one of the best examples comes from Matthew 15. Jesus and his disciples had just crossed over into the Gentile lands, into the land of Tyre and Sidon. And when they did this, this unexpected person came up to them. It's interesting. God's pop quizzes often come in the form of a person. Matthew 15:22. A Canaanite woman from that vicinity came up to him, crying out, "Lord, Son of David, have mercy on me. My daughter is demon-possessed and suffering terribly." Sometimes God pops quizzes can be so inconvenient. You're in a hurry. You're on a time schedule. Maybe you're feeling tired. Maybe you're feeling irritable when an unexpected person with a need shows up right at the wrong time. What did Jesus say? Well, the scriptures tell us he did not answer a word. It's as if he stood back, he looked at his disciples, nodded his head, and thought, okay, get out a pencil and paper. Now's the time for a pop quiz. The disciples, how did they react to this surprise text? They said, "Lord, send this woman away. She's irritating. She keeps bothering us." I'm guessing Jesus shook his head and marked down their grade in the teacher's book, F minus. Sometimes we learn more when we fail. How would Jesus present this important lesson of this encounter with this Canaanite woman? Well, first, he took the disciples' perspective to draw them in and help them to see where they had stalled out spiritually. Matthew 15:24-26, he answered, "I was sent only to the lost sheep of Israel." In other words, I can't minister to you Gentiles, so I'm called to minister to the Israelites. The woman came and knelt before him. "Lord, help me," she said. He replied, "It's not right to take the children's bread and toss it to the dogs underneath the table." This sounds very harsh. It sounds prejudiced and callous. But Jesus was using this circumstance to test these disciples. He wasn't going to show his cards yet. He was going to go from this side where the disciples were, and he was going to flip it over to the other side. This is how it happened. Matthew 15:27-28. "Yes, it is, Lord," she said. "Even the dogs eat the crumbs that fall from the master's table." Then Jesus said to her, "Woman, you have great faith. Your request is granted." And her daughter was healed at that moment. So suddenly the tables are turned. This Gentile woman goes from being called a dog to being called one of the greatest examples of faith that we have in Scripture. This pop quiz that the disciples took when they looked at the results, they saw that red F. Did you ever get a red F on a test? I don't think anybody here had, but I did. Oh, and I see a couple people nodding now. Oh man, I hate to see those red Fs on a paper. But it was one of the biggest lessons that they needed to learn in life. God loves all people. God loves all people equally. No one's lower than someone else. When God judges, it is according to character, not the color of the skin or the cultural background. This Gentile woman came along with a deep need. Her daughter was in trouble. This was a test for the disciples. Could the disciples see beyond culture and beyond color and the differences to share God's love and power with this woman? Well, eventually, they learned this lesson. That's why we're here this morning. We're Gentiles. We're not Jews. We're Gentiles. The doors of heaven have been opened wide to all people. That's why we're here. Listen. It's very possible that sometime this week, God might say to you, get out a pencil and paper. A test might come this week. That pop quiz, I'm going to tell you right now, will probably come in the form of a person. Be prepared. To pass, you must allow the love and the power of God to flow from you to that person. When that test comes, may God help us be ready. Amen. Let's turn to our final hymn number 410. My faith looks up to me.